Like, yo, let me get a verse on your album. My album's out. Oh, let me get a verse on your next album. How you doing? What's your name?
Louis Stone Cold.
Okay.
I want to do a song with you, too. I'm a rapper, man.
Oh, okay.
And where are we headed for?
We're going to go to my old house, and I'm going to knock on the door and see if I can get in because I left something in my room.
Okay.
I'm going up over the curb, driving on the median. Finally made it home, but I don't got the key to get in.
They put a new door on.
They fixed the place up.
Yeah.
They've been shoveling the snow.
Actually, it doesn't look that bad. My name is Slim Shady. I wanted to know if we could come in and take a look around. I'm with MTV right now. I used to live in this house.
The current resident of M's old house wasn't up for a home TV invasion, but the porch was available, as good a place as any to sift through some of the critical flack that's greeted his sometimes disturbing Slim Shady LP, whose main themes, according to one prominent music industry critic, include drugging, raping, and murdering women.
While you at work, she's with some dude trying to get off, slitting her throat, cut this bitch's head off.
You've gotten a lot of flack from various quarters. I mean, Timothy White, the executive editor of Billboard, wrote that editorial, and he was objecting to, you know, guilty conscience. And, I mean, what would you say to him if you were here?
I would say that he needs to listen to more rap music, and he needs to live a little bit, because he took every word that I said in Guilty Conscience so literal. And that whole song, anybody with half a brain can see that that whole song was just talking about ways of the world and your conscience. And like, it's a concept song, you know, it's a concept. It's like, you got the bad half of you and you got the evil half. And it seems like nowadays in America, like, just the evil side always rules. And that's what I was trying to show with that song.
Another Slim Shady track, 97 Bonnie and Clyde, concerns a young man not unlike single father M himself, who takes murderous revenge on the unfaithful mother of his baby girl.
And mama said she wants to show you how far she can float. And don't worry about that little boob you want to throw. It's just a little scratch, it don't hurt.
Further illuminating the song's horrific scenario is the album's cover, which shows M with his real-life daughter.
Just in front of the cameras at that photo shoot, she was just such a little head, and she was like 2 years old at the time. You know, and everything I said to do, like, look in the trunk, baby. And she's looking in the trunk, and then she's waving bye-bye, you know.
And what is she thinking, like, why are you positioning Mama that way? She's, like, dead in the trunk, you're going to throw in the water. And did she think that was, like, a bad idea?
No, she didn't understand. And when she gets older, I'm going to have a lot of explaining to do for that song.
I would imagine.
You know, yeah. And
what did her mother think about it? Has she gotten back in touch with you about this?
Yeah.
How does she feel?
She flipped out, because we had broke up for a little while, and we went through a lot of issues. I mean, we still go through issues, you know, but we had broken up for a little while, and we went through a lot of stuff, and I was very mad at the time, you know, and just that's what I felt like writing. So I wrote the song, and then we had got back together like a couple of weeks later after I had finished the song. So I played it for her, and then we had broken up again, you know. She flipped out. She really flipped out.
99% of my life I was lied to. I just found out my mom does more dope than I do.
Me and my mother had a lot of family problems, a lot of problems just growing up, and I don't know, we argued a lot.
Where'd your dad go? Did you know?
Nah, I never met my father.
You may be hearing from him soon.
I heard that he lives in California, and I heard that he was trying to get in contact with me or whatever, but...
Would you be up for that?
Nah, not now. Not now, because I never got, like, one letter. I never got anything from him, you know?
Don't you want to grow up to be just like me?
What do you think when people say, think you should be, you know, is this guy a good role model? You know, he didn't finish school. Is it good for kids to hear this? I mean... What do you tell kids?
I don't feel like my stuff is really good for children. I don't feel like it really is good for stuff. Some songs I got, yeah, they're radio listenable or whatever, you know. But I don't know, like, most of my stuff as a whole is just, that's why there's an explicit lyric sticker on the cover, you know, to show kids there is a clean version and there's the regular version. So, you know, kids under 18 ain't supposed to get it.
Yeah.
And I'm not, I can't be a babysitter.
Every single day in Detroit, if rappers want to step to me, they better get to the point, because they don't understand the way that I do with the fluid that I be spitting. It's never written, because I'm always bitten.
Hey, yo, you make your neck crack like a snare pop. We're fresh, and they're I'm not.
Most rap, like rap guys, established rap guys have been pretty receptive to you. They've been helpful.
Yeah.
Some of them are difficult.
Yeah, like Busta Rhymes.
I like Eminem. He got lyrics.
I listen to that whole album. He coming from his soul. And if that's how he feel, if y'all feel him, rock with it. If you don't mess with it. That's the motto right there. Love it or leave it alone.
So life is better now, right?
Yeah, life is definitely better now. I don't want it to get much better. I won't have anything to rap about if it does, you know?
That could be a problem. What would happen if it just got so good that there was nothing bad to say? Like, then the ballads would come out.
Yeah, then the love songs. The love songs and the 80s remakes.
My earliest memories of hip-hop was just like being in the sixth grade. If you could break dance in our school, you would have...
It's amazing. Anyway, I'm just gonna sit back and watch it, because anybody who had doubts about Dre or was, you know, just wondering if he fell off or whatever, just gonna get hit in the head. I'm telling you, that it's gonna be so unsuspecting, just because, you know, people think that it's been so dry. It's just been a dry spell for Dre, and he's just, you know, he's washed up. He did all he could do. That's not even true.